religious dialogue. Last, but definitely not least today about Auschwitz, we will learn about education for citizenship and peace, work with these centers. And it will be presented by Mrs. Barbara Santibanez, who is a policy researcher specialized in education, currently working as a research fellow at the University of Padua in Italy. An avid learner and curious about the world in general, she is interested in projects related to human rights, education, conflict resolution, and peace building. Barbara has worked for a number of international organizations such as IIEP, UNESCO, the Council of Europe, Amnesty International, and Inter-American Development Bank, and the Water Innovation Summit for Education, among others. Also, she is registered expert at the European Knowledge Center for Youth Policy. In between 2015 and 2017, she was a Rotary Peace Fellow at the Duke and UNC Rotary Peace Center, where she completed a Master's in Global Policy at UNC and a certificate at International Development Policy at Duke University. Please welcome Mrs. Barbara Santibanez, Rotary Peace alumnus.
Bonjour, mesdames, messieurs. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Alan Wesley, president. My name is Barbara, as I was introduced, and I am a Peace Fellow from the Duke UNC Center located in North Carolina, United States. There, between 2015 and 17, I followed a Master's in Global Policy, which allowed me to give a step further in my career as a specialist in education and human rights. Before becoming a Peace Fellow, I worked for different international organizations, such as Amnesty International and the Inter-American Development Bank, in projects related to human rights, advocacy, and international development. As you already know, the five peace centers around the world provide us fellows with a unique opportunity to specialize in our domains of interest while preparing us to have a significant and positive impact on peace and conflict resolution throughout our future careers. My experience as a Peace Fellow not only opened many doors in terms of professional development, for instance, as part of my applied field experience, I worked for the Council of Europe writing a chapter on the 2016 report on the state of citizenship and human rights education in Europe. The fellowship also gave me the chance to become part of a community of like-minded people that shared an interest in finding solutions to today's most pressing issues in relation to sustainable development. In spite of the diversity of professional areas, from public health to security, including disaster risk management, human rights, and education, of course, we all share the same goal, contributing to the achievement of more peaceful and equal societies. As for me, I deeply believe that to build long-lasting peace, education is key. In the words of Nelson Mandela, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. But it's, as it has been said before, education requires a long-term commitment from learners, parents, the school community, and of course, society at large. Education also needs a purpose that goes beyond equipping learners with skills for the job market. As a popular saying goes, educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. Now, Sustainable Development Goal number 4 puts forward this idea of providing quality education to all, and Rotary shares the same goal as one of its six areas of focus. Peace building is, as well, a key area for Rotary's work. Today's conference is a great opportunity to reflect on how Rotary and UNESCO are making and can continue making a difference in relation to the SDGs, and more specifically in education for peacebuilding and sustainable development. You have probably heard about concepts such as global citizenship education, peace education, and even maybe human rights education. These are fascinating concepts, to me at least, but they may seem unfamiliar to some of you. Well, let me tell you, the Rotary Peace Fellowship is certainly a great example of how education with a purpose is crucial to educate not only the minds, but also the hearts. As I said earlier, the fellowship not only provides extraordinary professional opportunities. As peace fellows, we bear also responsibility for contributing to building more peaceful societies. Wherever we go, with the skills we develop as part of our commitment to the fellowship. This initiative shows that education for peace building can not only change the lives of those who are chosen to become peace fellows, it will also change the lives of those who will benefit from the work that us peace fellows will be doing in our future careers. Unfortunately, not everyone has the chance to become a peace fellow. So, what can we do to educate and elevate tomorrow's citizens? What purpose do we give to education so that everyone has the chance to contribute to the sustainable development agenda? One key answer is to be found in SDG 4.7 that says that by 2030, all learners should acquire the knowledge and skills needed to promote sustainable development through education for human rights, gender equality, promotion of a culture of peace, global citizenship, and appreciation of cultural diversity. We all agree, of course, that in order to coexist peacefully, we have to learn to respect each other and to uphold the values of human rights. And in this regard, I would like to bring a personal take on how we are educating the citizens of tomorrow. It is personal because, of course, it's related to my own background and past experiences. I was born and grew up in the last years of the dictatorship in Chile, where basic freedoms and rights were suspended for 17 years. From a very young age, I became convinced of the importance of fostering dialogue in conflicted societies and educating others about the value of human dignity and the fundamental principles of human rights. So yes, education for peace can be a life-changing experience, as it was for me. And education for peace can happen not only in the classroom. For instance, the work Rotaract is also doing with young people is a good example on how we can educate the minds while infusing values of service, mutual understanding, and intercultural dialogue, for instance. There are multiple initiatives and projects within Rotary aiming at fostering sustainable and peaceful societies, and each of us can play a significant role. As an education and human rights practitioner, I am myself working towards giving others the opportunity to learn about the importance of these values, human rights, gender equality, the culture of peace, and to put them into practice in our everyday lives. And today, as part of this panel on building peaceful societies, I would like to invite you to reflect on how together we can make a difference while working for protecting the planet, ensuring a dignified life, and ultimately building a peaceful and equal society for all. Thank you.